Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we want to start converting the design of screens in Figma to the React Native app. And also using TypeScript, we will create a custom component to use in all screens. Well, we go to initial screen, and as you saw in the previous session, we created it this way. In the first part, we designed the screens in Figma, and now we use them to create the page in React Native. First, I delete this text and replace it with the image background component to use it to add a background image to the screen. We previously put the images in the assets folder and exported them to this file. Now we use the image related to this screen here. Well, the image is not displayed, and we have to define a style for it. Define the style so that the background image covers the entire screen and the contents are in the center. Well, as you can see, the image is displayed correctly. Now we complete the contents of the screen. We should display the logo at the top of the page. This time we use the image component and define the logo image from the assets folder inside it. And we consider a suitable style for it. For sizes, we use RF value to change on different devices to fit the screen size. Now under the logo, we put a text according to the design screen. And we define its style. Now at the bottom of the screen, I create a view as a footer to put the buttons in it. Because the button is repeated in the same way on all screens, we create it as a custom component so that we can use it more easily. Well, in the SRC folder, I create a folder called Components. and consider a separate folder for the button component. And in this folder, I create index and styles files. First, I create the button function simply. And to define its props, I use interface to define their type. Button title as a string, button onPress function as a simple function, button disabled or enabled as a boolean, button style as view style, and button title style as text style. Now we use these props inside the button function. Well, now we create the button using the pressable component and use the props inside it. Now we create its style structure using useMemo. I'm not completing the style at the moment, so that we can test the result at the right time. Well, here I define the style as an array to first put the default style in it, and then use the props inside it. In addition to the fact that we can transfer to desired style to this component through the prop, I want the color to change if the button is disabled, so that the user notices that the button is disabled. Well, now we create a text inside the pressable component as a button title. And we define its style as an array. Well, now we can use the component we created in this screen. First, we define its title. The button will always be enabled on this page. And by pressing the button, we want to move to the next screen using the navigation that we have already defined. Here we have to move to sign up screen by pressing the main button. Well, as you can see, the button is displayed here. But since we didn't define its style, it doesn't look good. So I define its style in a way that is similar to our design in Figma. Now under the button, we use a parsable to be able to create a clickable text. The user must be transferred to sign in a screen by pressing this text. Now we define its style to be similar to the original design. As you can see by pressing the buttons, we are transferred to the desired screens. If you look at the top of the screen, you will see that the status bar remains in the dark. And because our background image is also in the dark, the status bar is not readable. To be able to control the status bar on the device when the app is running, we can use the status bar component from React Native. And if we use it in the main file of the app, it will be applied to all screens. I choose the background color as transparent. To style it, you can choose three options. The default mode follows the current theme of the device. And here we select the light mode. This prop actually ensures the transparency of the bar. Well, as you can see, the status bar is displayed with the light theme and will be the same on all screens. So there we go. In this session, we created the initial screen of the app, and using the TypeScript, we created a button as a custom component. In the next session, we will change the structure of the app in such a way that the language of the app will change according to the current language of the device. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next video.